Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to discuss about 1D array in Java. Before starting, if you are facing a visibility problem in this video while watching, you can improve the pixel quality by going into the setting option. So by finishing this quality improvement, you can note down these information for your study and placement purposes. Now coming on to the topic, 1D arrays. So arrays are data structures consisting of related data items of the same type. So I hope you have studied C and C++. So in both the languages, we also use arrays. So array contains elements of similar data types under a single variable. So arrays are fixed length entities. They remain the same length once they are created. Although an array variable may be reassigned such that it refers to a new array of a different length. So this can be done only in Java. After creation of array, we can assign different length to the object of the array. So now we have to understand how we can declare and define an array. So in Java, working of array is same, but its memory allocation and initialization process is little bit different with C and C++. So in Java, array creation is a two-way process. First, we declare the array variable, and second, we define the array variable. So these are the declaration. We can declare array in two different manners. These statements show the declaration of the array. No memory is allocated to ARR at this time. So this is the purely declaration statement. Now ARR equals to new int 5. So this statement is allocating memory to this ARR array. So this statement create an array of 5 integers and reference is assigned to the ARR. So you can say that array works like an object in Java. So in Java, whenever array is created, all the elements of array are allocated to its default value. So this is done by default. All integer locations will be initialized by 0, then boolean with false, character with null character, float with 0.0, and object type of array will occupy null value. After declaration and defining array, initialization of array is available. So this first statement is similar to C and C++, but second is different. Here B array is created and it is receiving reference of A. So now array reference is assigned into the B. So new copy of array object is not created. Both will point to the same array. So in this case, the B array will point to the location which is occupied by A. So in Java, each array has length variable, which is used to calculate the length of the array element. So this is also new in Java. Suppose you have declared an array A. So you can calculate its length using a.length. A is the name of array and length is the attribute of this array. So this statement will print 4 because array contains total 4 elements. Now example. So first line is the comment, which is showing how or what name we can use to store this source code. Then public class init array 1, public modifier, then class keyword, then init array 1 is name of class. Then public static void main, then for command line argument, I have used args array, which is of string type. String is a class. Main is a method in which I have defined various statements. So int array is array declaration, then array equals to new int n. It is memory allocation to array. Then system.out.println will print this message on console, index and value. So notice that I have used plus here. Plus is used to separate these two strings. So in C we use comma operator. In C++, we use insertion operator, but in Java, we have to use plus. Then for loop is used, int counter equals to 0. So similar to C++, in Java, we can also declare a variable inside the loop. condition is counter length less than array dot length. So array dot length will find out the total number of elements which are available inside the array. Then counter plus plus will increase counter variable by one. Then system dot out dot println will print a value of counter, means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then plus is for separation. Then space will be printed. Again plus is for separation. Then array and counter will be denoting the index value. So this array counter will print the element which is available on a particular index. So output will be it will print a counter will print 0. Then array counter will print element on 0th index. Then in next line 1 and index the value which is available on index number 1. So and so on, all the 10 elements will be printed. So I have not assigned any value to this array. So this array will print 10 times 0. It means each index will be containing 0 value, because in Java array is assigned default values automatically. So with the help of this program, you can implement these problems. Write a program to read 10 numbers from user and print their sum. So in my previous tutorials, I have mentioned how we can read elements from the user. So you can take a look on that video. With the help of that video and this video, you can implement the first program. Then to read two 1D arrays of 10 elements each and store their sum into third array, you can also implement this program. Then print reverse of an array, you can also implement this program. So in these programs, you have to use loop as well as 1D array. So implement these programs on your laptop or desktop so that you can understand the concept which is used in array in case of Java. So in Java, arrays working is a little bit different. It is different in C++ and it is different in Java. So these are my information which will be helpful for your placement purposes. Thank you for watching this video.